Start by importing the video clip. In order to make a composition that matches the video, drag the clip down to the Create Comp icon. Double-click on the layer in order to bring up its settings. Find and place the correct in and out points for your project. Finish by closing the layer view. Open up composition settings and adjust the duration to match the length of the layer. As you can see by scrubbing the timeline, the head is moving even though it should be stable. In order to fix this, we're going to stabilize the clip. With the layer still selected, choose Stabilize from the menu Animation. Select Options to account for rotation. Place the two track points on the helmet. Click the Play button and let After Effects go through the entire clip. When stabilizing is complete, click Apply and select X and Y to finalize the process. If you scrub the timeline, you will notice that the head is more stable. That's because After Effects have moved and rotated the layer in order to compensate for the head motion. This is noticeable by the black border occurring at the edge of the video. Next step is to mask out the portion of the picture that isn't needed for our motion capture. Create a solid with a color black and the same resolution as the comp. Select the Eclipse tool and cover the face. Expose the solid's mask setting and select Inverted. Adjust the amount of feather to make a smooth edge. Tweak the shape to make sure that none of the markers slips outside of the mask. Choose Make Movie in order to render out the sequence. Click on the lossless text and bring up render settings. Choose JPEG sequence as file format. Make sure to set the quality to maximum. Click on Output to select where the sequence should be saved. Place a dot between your chosen file name and the brackets. Click Render and your sequence will be produced. Save your project and move on to part 2.